Hello everyone, our today's topic is Simon's classification. So Simon's classification में जो dental arches हैं उनको तीन anthropologic planes में relate किया गया है. Since malocclusion is a three-dimensional problem, Simon devised this method of classification orienting dental arch to three different planes. It is a craniometric form of classification. Now, what are the three planes that are used? It is sagittal plane, FH plane, Frankfurt horizontal plane, and the orbital plane. So, first of all, Frankfurt horizontal plane or the eye ear plane, EEP. Now, ye plane kaisa hota hai? By drawing a line through the margin of inferior orbit below the eyeball and upper margin of auditory meatus. See, the one which is marked as Z, that is the FH plane. How is it obtained? Ek line hum log banayenge margin of inferior orbit below the eyeball and upper margin of auditory meatus se. It is the eye ear plane. So this plane helps to detect the deviations in vertical plane. Vertical जो major deviations होंगे. Height of the dental arches and teeth is related to the cranium, इसके help से. So अगर dental arch closer है plane के तो it is attraction, and if it is away from the plane it is abstraction. See, in first the dental arch is closer to the FH plane, so it is mandibular attraction. In second it is farther away from the FH plane, so it is mandibular abstraction. Now next is orbital plane. Ab ye plane kaise milta hai? A line perpendicular to the FH plane at the margin of bony orbit below the pupil. ठीक है, FH plane के perpendicular हम एक line बनाएंगे कहाँ पे? Bony orbit below the pupil. So that is the orbital plane. This plane helps to detect the deviations in sagittal direction. Okay, sagittal plane में ये deviations को detect करने में help करता है. Now anterior posterior relationship of the dental arches. It tells about the anterior posterior relationship of the dental arches and the axial inclination of the teeth. इन दोनों को relate करता है किससे? Cranium से. So dental arch which is more anteriorly placed is called protraction, and which is posteriorly placed is called retraction. Once again, if we see the figure, see the plane which is marked as Z, that is orbital plane. It is perpendicular to the FH plane. अब देखो इसमें अगर dental arch closer है तो और dental arch pass है तो ये anterior posterior relationship बताता है. ठीक है, protraction and retraction. Next is raphe median plane, RMP, or mid sagittal plane. This plane is obtained by drawing lines through mid palatal raphe at right angles to the FH plane. The plane which is marked as Y, this is the mid sagittal plane. Okay, so this plane helps to detect the deviations in transverse direction. The mediolateral relationship of dental arches and the axial inclination of the teeth is related to the midline of the head. अब अगर closer है to mid sagittal plane तो contraction होगा, और अगर उससे away है तो distraction होगा. ठीक है, तो mid sagittal plane क्या बोलता है? Contraction और distraction. Orbital plane protraction and retraction. Now see, this is first is distraction. तो ये mid sagittal plane है उससे दूर, तो it is distraction. If it is closer to the mid sagittal plane, it is distraction. If it is closer, it is contraction. और अगर it is दूर, तो it is distraction. So that is it about Simon's classification. Thank you. Keep visiting.